Everyone, welcome back to Dragalia Lost. So I promised you guys a discussion video about the recent chapter, and so here we are. I also wanted to do a quick bit of news roundup. As usual, we have the Agito coming on Friday, so after I return, so no problem there. I can safely return without worrying about the Agito video. It will likely drop together with the new event and maybe the new Gala banner. So it will be a tight schedule. It's likely that I will do the Gacha and then I will focus on doing the Agito video, and after that I will continue with the story if you guys don't mind. Of course, I did tell you guys that I'm not sure if I will pull on the banner for the characters, so the story are kind up there, so that's why I decided to put them after the Agito fight. The next event should be a facility, it should be fire, and after that we should also have the anniversary first news. Probably not something substantial, because the news for the anniversary should come into a Dragalia digest, but who knows, maybe we get the digest on the 1st of September. I'm really excited for the anniversary, hopefully we get something good, but before we get to that point, we have another week to go through. So what content will I bring? We have today we have the discussion for the story, then we have, as you can tell, a crescendo of courage event story. After that I will do some further event, adventure stories that I have left, like Nicholas, I think, and Linus are some 3-star adventure stories that I left, and when I return I will go back to do some of the more complicated videos, like the adventurers against Agito that I do sometimes during a week. After that I might want to start a new series that I already have in mind, but I will tell you more about that later. So for now, let's jump into the story discussion. I will go through each topic without a specific order, but I recommend that you guys watch the recent story and also some adventure stories that I have uploaded to better get an understanding of what I'm about to tell you. Meanwhile, I will do some background content, so hopefully you guys won't mind too much if I screw up and stuff. It is the usual flavor because I am focused on talking to you guys, so it can happen. So, first topic about the story. We got finally, and I really underline the finally, a really nice character development in the fourth sibling, which is Valix. We got a little more insight on why he is so focused on being sort of a guard-like character and isn't really interested in the race for the throne that we saw in the first chapters of the game. And his character is something really interesting that we haven't seen before so far in the game. He's sort of like a proto-Yuden, but he didn't have the courage to confront his siblings, and instead he become sort of like a test for his siblings to become king. To better explain it, Valix is like the final test that a king has to surpass to become worthy to his eyes. However, this kinda contradicts what we saw with Zelia, because of course the other wasn't a worthy emperor, but Valix still works under a regiment of power, it seems like, so who knows what his standards will be. I am not sure what the story will go with him. We saw him unleash his dragon, so the most powerful form that he has. We also saw him underploy some rather unconventional tactics by going straight against Nedric in the first chapter of the story. And I am kinda curious to see if they plan to add him as a Gala character for the anniversary. I don't think they will personally, but who knows. Stuff changes, we might get something really really interesting for the anniversary. Personally, I'd rather prefer if they gave us Gala Xena, because it makes a little bit more sense, at least to me. Then you guys maybe have a different perspective on who you want for the anniversary. Let me know in the comments who you want to see. Maybe you want Zetia, even though we saw that she went back to being a dancer in distress. Something that we kinda expected, I must be honest with you. But it is what it is. So, Valix. He also had the reveal of his dragon, at least as a sprite. We already saw him in the chapter 5. Its name Thor. It is likely going to be a gala light dragon, which begs me to question which dragon we will get at the end of the month, since it should be a wind dragon, and this team really sucks, mostly because it is full of fjorms who aren't really suited to do this kind of content, since two fjorms aren't really good enough. Okay, so let's talk about Nedric. So Nedric was finally revealed to be the seventh Scion, to the surprise of probably no one, at least not mine. And I really enjoy his character. He's probably the cool villain of the series, and maybe later on he will be an anti-hero. And his motives so far aren't really clear. He seems to be concerned with the Dawnshard and the territories that are beyond our reach so far, which are the Northern territories. We know that in the north we have the territory of Victor and Kirsty, we have a fairy territory, and we have the land from where Yuden came from. So for sure, after the next chapter, which will still be in the central Grestea, we will see some really new scenarios forming up in the main story, which I am really excited about. So, if I had to take a guess, Nedric probably wants to change the past, probably go back in a time where he can change what happened to him to his birth, and maybe, who knows, maybe wants to kill Aurelius, since we saw that he didn't have a really friendly talk about him when he confronted Yuden. He also seems to harbor a personal vendetta against Yuden, which we kinda all expected, and his reveal was also kind of funny if you think about this guy going against you with this book and telling you place your hand on this book, and if it opens you are a royal descendant, if it doesn't you aren't, and he does it really calmly too, so that was kinda entertaining to watch, I must say. He also seems to be the main employer of Diaghito, that's also something that we all kinda expected. I have to say, I am kinda confused about the masks, because we saw that he used the mask to sort of control Valix, but it wasn't really a true control, it was more enhancing his true feelings. So I wonder if the Aghito have the same effect with their mask, because we saw that EX chapter that I decided to add into the story kinda presenting us with a hint that the Aghito are sort of insane because of their mask, at least the Queens aren't really that sane to me. But we will see, that's a plot point that is likely to be explored in future chapters. I also rather enjoy that they teased us with Tartarus. As expected, he's going to be the foil to Cleo, and as a foil, he's going to be part of Alberius, entourage. He was also confirmed to be a dragon in the official preview of the Aghito fight, so that's going to be interesting, because it means that his transformed form is likely to be a dragon. I wonder which type, maybe some dragon that we haven't seen. And yeah, that's all about Nedric. We didn't get a ton about him, we just know that he's likely wanted to use Zetia to use the Dawnshard, which is an interesting plot point, because we know that the Dawnshard can be used to travel through time, which is something that we didn't really see yet in the story, apart from Xena. So next, let's talk about her, Xena. So she was the main star of the chapter, for sure. We got a ton more insight into her personal story and motivation going forward into the main story. I look forward to see her interact with the other sibling, for sure, because we never saw the other sibling acknowledge her apart from Fares, which probably is one of the most annoying siblings, so I don't really want to see Chell and Leonidas interact with him, for sure. So, we don't know if Xena will be a gala. I actually expect her to be, since we all thought about Zedia being the gala unit. And what better way to add a new unit than to add the other version of that unit as the gala? Personally, I won't mind if she's a light healer, as many are expecting, since we don't really have any light healer apart from Hildegard, which actually reached absurd levels with her strength thanks to the mana spiral. And yeah, she also has shown to have some incredible powers together with Xena. I wonder if those powers will come to light later on in the story again. I don't know about that. I think that they will, if they stick to the story. They have shown that they are incredibly powerful even together. It was kind of a way to save her from going up back to her own time, but I do expect that those powers will come back, since they are the same person in the end. Whatever Xena can do, Zedia should be able to do it as well, so I'm not really worrying a ton about that. And I screwed up there, I kinda rolled into my death, so that's kinda bad. Hopefully those guys won't mind too much. Okay, now let me check my notepad. Ah, yes, of course, we should talk about Ellie. So we finally got the cat out of the bag for Ellie. It didn't really bring to anything substantial though. I actually expected more about the reveal, but it is what it is. So we also saw that Alex was the voice of reason for Ellie, which I kinda expected, since she was shown to be the person that understands Ellie the most, which is kinda understandable since they are childhood friends and more. And she's shown to want to get more powerful in the future, which I guess can kinda tie with the future plot hook that we got for the next chapter, which I will discuss later on. So we know that from the church stories that Allison actually has a secret power inside of her that the rebels in the church want to use. This power can be unlocked only by killing her, which we saw that the assassin in the Gala Alex story wanted to do, and this plotline is still left open. We have a ton of characters into the church plotline, like Alex, Ellie, we have Curran, we have Giulietta, we have Tobias, we have Hope, a ton of them. And this plotline seems to be probably brought into the main story, since the church was name-dropped a ton of times. And I'm curious to see where it will bring Allison and the other characters inside of this plotline. Who knows if we get it in the next chapter, because the next chapter tease, which we will talk right now, actually talks about Alone Paladin. My guess is that it could be Tobias, since the last time we saw him in his adventure story, he was headed to the north, so maybe that's where the spirit of adventure will lead him, and it will tie with Leonidas coming back to give us a plot exposition for what happened in the north. Who knows? Okay, so let's see what else we have to discuss. Of course, Yuden is the last thing that we have left. The three, Don't Shell, the Mask for Valix, Tartarus, this for next chapter, Valix Fate. Okay. So, last but not least, our dear Yuden. Man, I actually have to be honest with you guys. I don't like how they dealt with him breaking, because I wanted the characters to be way more aggressive with the fact that he kinda ditched their life in the previous chapter. And that didn't happen until the end, until he basically broke as a character, because all the royalty stuff, all the Aurelius, Alberius bloodline in him broke, and etc. And all that he had left was the fact that he wanted Zedia, shown in the attack against Nedric where he went Zedia, Zedia, etc, etc. And then the characters told him, man, we have to rest, we have to heal up, etc. No, we have to save Zedia, etc. And all the characters went like, you are being stupid, go away. He went away, he got calmed by Xena, and he was given, finally, because this is, will be probably the most interesting part of the next chapter, he was told that he needs to build his own character. So the future will probably bring us to the original character that was meant to be for Yuden. And I am really curious for which this character will be. It will likely be similar to the past Yuden, but I think that he will be probably less royal and more selfish. He will be kinda like the adventurer story Yuden, where he was meme to be party boy Yuden, if you catch my drift. So I also expect that we will likely get a resolution about the bloodline stuff in the next chapter, when the general populace, man, why does Lily have to be so slow with the first attack? It was kinda my bad, but she's way too slow. I thought that they buffed that, to be honest, so that's why I was starting to use it a little bit more. But as I was saying, So you, the next chapter, you will have to confront the general populace, because we saw the preview saying that the dragons and the people are on the rise for whatever reason. And I wonder what that will bring, because we know that in the capital we have Emil, we have Chell that probably rescued Valix, which is the Valix fate that I was talking earlier, because the interlude that is about two things, that Leonidas was going to the north to listen to what Alberius told him to discover, and Chell was going to save Euden because they knew about Nedrit and they wanted to save him. So I wonder what that will bring. I wonder what will happen. I'm really curious about that myself. And that's something that we will deal with in the next chapter. About Euden, we now see that there is kind of an hint, if I am honest with you guys, that his obsession with Zedia isn't kinda real, that it is kinda something programmed into him, which maybe will tie with the fact that he is sort of a vessel for someone else. My guess is that he is the vessel for the dragon god, whatever it's called, Elysium. Since he does transform into Elysium, he does have this weird thing where he can transform into all the dragons. He can make a ton of dragon path, and it wasn't really explained. So that will be another thing that we have to discover. Why Euden is able to form dragon paths? Why he's able to form multiple dragon paths? Why the dragon trust him to continue the Dragalia Lost? Which, if you don't know the meaning, go check out the High Dragon Trials stories. It's actually a really cool thing that they teased about. And man, she did it really early. Usually she does some other attacks before she does that thing. Okay, so after this Agito run, we are done with the story discussion, because Euden was the last thing, of course. What else is there to say? I am actually really curious about the main story. Chapter 16 will come after the anniversary, so you guys will have to wait about that. It will come in, I think, late October. And it will start the new age of Dragalia Lost. I also have heard that this is actually stuff that's not confirmed, so don't take it at face value or anything, that there was a leak about the next Nintendo Direct that should come, if I'm not wrong, next week. It seems like that's the general plan. And they said that there is a Dragalia Lost game for the Switch in planning. If that's true, that's kinda huge news, because you know, guys, that the game doesn't do that well in Japan, so that could probably help the game become more mainstream there, and help it stay on its feet without doing some weird marketing tactics. That will coincide also with the anniversary, so the timing is there that it could make sense to be true, but we will see. Don't take this as true, it's still not confirmed. I myself am kinda skeptical about it, but we will have to see. It is kinda something that's not expected, that is not known to be true, etc, 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 so we'll have to see. What else is there to say? I will have to end the Agito fight to finish the video, so I am running out of topics, so I hope that you guys have enjoyed the main story chapter. Let me know in the comments if you did. I kinda don't see many of you discussing the comments about such stuff, but I know that many of you prefer just to watch, so it is what it is. Hopefully you enjoyed this talk. It wasn't in as depth as the other ones, but I am still on vacation, so I have to adapt to my surroundings and use what I have, in this case a notepad on my PC, on my laptop rather, not even a PC. I have to remember to do one more of the Agito before the weekends. I am actually starting to build some water weapons for whatever reason, and that's it. So hopefully you guys will join me next time for the Gacha and the Agito. Hopefully you pass another wonderful week, and remember, if you enjoyed the video, to leave a like and a sub. This is Hunter Lodge with another story discussion, and I hope that you have enjoyed it. Bye!